is Bloomberg UTV.
Isn't it? And you're thinking that the person who owns them all has got to be a millionaire. Well, you are right about that, but do consider the fact that this young man actually turned a millionaire when he was just 18 years old. Not bad, I'd say, considering that he turned an entrepreneur when he was just 16 years old. Intriguing, isn't he? Let's find out his story.
Started computer programming at the age of 8, offered freelance consulting at 14. At 16, set up his own company. And today, at 26, he is the proud owner of a $300 million company. That's Divyank Turakhia, the founder of Directi, a company that develops mass market web products for millions of customers around the world. Directi today has several arms, such as Kenzo.com, which is in the internet traffic monetization business, webhosting.info that provides statistics and research to the web service industry, and logicboxes and resellerclub.com that are into domain registrations. Directi was founded by Divyank in 1998, at a time when the internet was still at its nascent stage. And at that time, the idea was only to follow a passion, almost an obsession that got Divyank reading up whatever he could get his hands on.
Used to love to tinker around with gadgets like all boys. Read a lot, so was very interested in business also, because right from when I was very, very young, I used to read a lot of biographies, biographies of companies, biographies of people. You know, I started young. When the internet came in, I figured that, you know, this is it. I think this is going to change the way people do any kind of activity in general, because of the way information becomes available to you. It becomes available to you at such a low cost and in real time that it's going to change the way we function, literally.
And is that when the idea of Directi really came about? Because you started it when you were 16.
So the idea of Directi came about slightly later.
Okay. So
when I was 14, I did freelance consulting for 2 years. I was essentially helping people set up on the internet. Which would be anything related to just getting them online, getting a website up for them, setting up their corporate email. 2 years I did that. I realized that the problem with what I was doing was that I could only manage X number of projects at any given point of time. So decided that, look, if I want to build something that's big, that's a large business, then I want to make sure that I start building something that's more mass market. We started a company that was selling domain names, selling web hosting space, and that's how we started out. Then we realized that our core competence was technology. And because our core competence was technology, the idea would be to license whatever we are building to as many people as possible.
You know, but the trend today seems to be that people want to customize their services for clients. So is that something...
Which is fair, right? I mean, it's a business model that has worked for various different businesses. It wasn't a business that I wanted to get into because it has scaling challenges. Now, obviously, back then when I started out Infosys or Wipro and TCS, they managed to figure out how to scale that model of building custom software for customers around the world, paying an employee $100 and they're getting paid $500 for the same thing. If someone's affording to pay that $500, it's only because they can make $5,000 from that.
Sure.
We'd rather be that company that's making the $5,000, right? So we'd rather be a products company, and we'd rather focus on building technology that we can license in one uniform fashion.
The stance of focusing on mass market products rather than focusing on the custom needs of a client worked in Divyank's favour. From a two-people company with an initial investment of 25,000 rupees, Directi today has around 600 employees and approximately 2 million customers across 230 countries.
What did it take to get the first clients on board?
It was pretty easy actually for us to get the first clients on board because I was already in the internet in the internet space for the last 2 years prior to starting Directi. Even though, you know, I was 16 then, I'd already worked for 2 years. And I'd worked with various corporate clients. So it was a matter of starting and talking to them, saying that, look, this is a new business that I've started. Why don't you send me some business? If you want to go online, now I can provide you these additional services. Very rapidly, like I said, in the first month, we got 40 customers. So we grew that piece very rapidly. Obviously, the much larger challenge was then from growing from the initial set of customers that we knew to then customers that we that didn't know us, had never heard of us, and so on and so forth. And that we did by leveraging, you know, the internet.
But did no one question the 16-year-old who had started up with loads of confidence? How did his clients respond when they learned they were giving business to a teenager?
The advantage of the internet is that the people don't really see you. Yeah. They basically see a website. Right? So that definitely was an advantage, especially when you are like, you know, 14, 16, 17 or whatever. But at the same time, what happens is the challenge exists until people have spoken to you. Because once they speak to you, then they realize that you know more than everybody else that they've spoken to. And as soon as that happens, automatically you've sold a customer. Right? As soon as you get X number of large customers working with you because of that sales cycle, then it becomes very easy because then you can, if someone new comes, you can just say that, look, these are the customers that I work for and that I've done work with, and you know, these are the numbers, go call them, right? And it works out.
So his knowledge of the web is what mattered more than the number we call age. But getting to a $300 million company takes more than that, especially in a market where a zillion internet solutions companies vie for the same clients. What is this young man doing differently to have scaled up his business to its current size?
The reason our clients choose us is because we figure out better solutions from a technology standpoint as compared to anybody else, which gives us an edge. We leverage the India advantage, of course, whereby we can basically recruit a lot more people for the same task, which makes sure that every individual client gets a lot more attention if they need it. But at the same time, we are lean also, so in the sense that we have a lot of automation in place where the client can self-serve and get a lot of the things that they want done for themselves.
What are some of the common problems that crop up on a day-to-day basis?
I think even when we grow from the 500-600 people that we are today to a 5,000 people company, we will still have a people problem because that's the problem that every large business in the world has. It's all about trying to identify how to source the right people and then how to basically incentivize them and how to empower them ongoingly in order to be able to take the right decisions.
An incentive he knows how to give. This winning warrior seems to have realized deeply that people make it thy business. And so Divyank Turakhia recruits from the biggest global B schools and works hard to keep his recruits happy.
We have a gym, we have a bowling alley that's coming up, we have a DVD library.
More on this young and restless winning warrior after the break.